you're standing around for 45 minutes in overtime waiting for all that stuff.
Yes.
Say your prayer then.
Sorry, I'm a little scratchy today.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in to today's webcast of the soccer match between the Lawrence University Vikings and the Monmouth College Scots. I'm CJ Rivas. I'll be bringing you the action. If you watch the women's game or are sticking with us through this one, thank you for continuing to tune in. Lawrence enters this game with a record of 3-13-1, 2-7 in the Midwest Conference. Monmouth entered this one 5-11-1 overall, 3-5-1 in the Midwest Conference. Neither team in contention to make the conference tournament. Both teams ending their season in this one, so both just looking to end the season on a positive note and have a nice send-off for their seniors.
Go get that, Joe.
Because that one's going to roll back to Joe Krivic. So we'll go down to the starting lineups first for Monmouth in goal. Connor Temple, number 6, Augustine Miranda, number 7, Justin Seeley, number 8, Carlos Ruiz, number 9, Luke Vandenberg, number 11, Daniel Guzman, number 12, Sebastian Heretic, number 13, Bryce Adams, number 15, Connor Oltman, number 16, Max Daniels, and number 18, Roman Clark, head coach of Monmouth in his third season. Cooten Johnson, his assistant, Quinn Johnson. Ball being played in the middle, Hoot with it. And now for the Viking. In goal, as always, Joe Krivic. Then we have Lewis Berger, Nick Huth, Santiago Alvarez, Michael Deramo, Jack Blodgett, Aaron Sutton, Max Lobel, Sean Slansky, Dominic Peschisi, and Ryan Leonard. Lawrence looks to get this one to the middle, and that one will go out of bounds for a corner kick. Santiago Alvarez and Aaron Sutton playing the last game of their careers here today. Both four-year players here at Lawrence. Both in the starting lineup. Here comes Santi with a shot. He sends that one way over the bar, and it'll go for a goal kick. Vikings come into this one after a loss at Wake Forest on the 25th. And before that, they beat Ripon on the 21st by a score of 2-0. Vikings trying to get a tag. Staying down, begging for a call, but nothing doing on that one. And Monmouth will try to get a counterattack here.
Who took the corner for us way back when?
17.
Santiago Alvarez comes up limping and believe he got hit in the hip.
Okay.
Free kick will be taken by Connor Oltman. Pass it to number 8, Carlos Ruiz, who I believe that was a shot on, or a shot attempt, and then that one will just roll wide, not a bounce, for a goal kick for the Vikings. That one's headed by Guzman. Sutton out with the header. This one's with Deramo. Looking for Blodgett running down the side.
Jack
he can't
Blodgett
get to it, though.
Viking of the week.
Number 15, Oldman got to it first.
Ripon.
2 goals and 11 stitches.
Is that how many stitches he had? Wow.
He's blowing up.
As he passes it back.
A hard-earned Viking.
Berger. Leonard with it, trying to make something happen. Gets stopped by the Monmouth defense.
Trey seems to have been Viking of the Week at some point.
I have no idea.
to be totally honest.
Troy got it first week, or first...
Seven threes.
...week. Season. Yeah, seven threes.
Monmouth will play it back to their back line, look at to set something
four,
up.
4-3-8.
So in the middle with Ruiz.
Arnabers, 3-48.
Alvarez intercepts that pass, gets it back. The pass is blocked by... believe number 9, Luke Vandenberg. Just 5 minutes into this one, 39 minutes, 35 seconds remaining in the first half.
Pioneers won the men's cross country.
Also, West Grinnell, okay.
Grinnell Pioneers, sorry. Forgot the Carroll Pioneers.
Lowell keeps that one alive on the far sideline. Deflected off the Lawrence player. Lawrence ends up with it. Here's Solanski. Gets past one defender, can't get past another. And the Scots have it again. One just going to be cleared by Monmouth. Pass from Sutton to Alvarez, gets intercepted. Sutton back with it. Here's Alvarez. Gets caught from behind by number 7, Justin Seeley. Dermo with a far pass to Solanski on the other sideline. His pass is intercepted. Throw in coming for the Vikings. Staying in bounds for now. It stays in bounds. Huth's going to get control of it, though. Nice pass from Ruiz at the beginning of this. They're going to call a foul on Lawrence as Vandenberg goes down. So free kick coming for the Scots. Takes a free kick. That one's just right at Privet.
Who took that?
He'll corral it. Earlier was raining, so field's still pretty wet. The rain has since stopped, though. But the ball will still probably be slippery, so the goalie's got to be very conscious of that. Other games going on in the conference today. We have Illinois College at Ripon, Cornell at Knox, and Beloit at Grinnell. Tomorrow, St. Norbert at Lake Forest, and Carroll at UW-Platteville. Three spots have already been determined for the conference tournament. St. Norbert leads the way right now with a 7-1-1 record. Carroll is next with 7-2-1, and Lake Forest at 7-2. So a huge game tomorrow in terms of seeding when St. Norbert travels to Lake Forest. Winner of that one could claim the top seed in the tournament. We have two teams battling out for the fourth and final spot in the conference tournament. That's Knox and Grinnell. Knox currently holds it with a 6-2-1 record. Grinnell right behind them at 6-3. So Grinnell needs a win at Beloit. And Knox lost today at Cornell. Well, pass across the field to number 12, Sebastian Heretic. Mishandled by the Scots and throwing coming for the Vikings. Vikings keep possession. Santiago Alvarez with it. Looks to find the net, but his shot is blocked. Lawrence still has a chance with the ball near the box. And Monmouth will clear it.
That's the other nice thing about not playing on the grass.
Was past the ceiling.
From our standpoint is they're
burgers there.
So
now Alvarez kicks it to the side where Blodgett is. That one will go out of bounds.
He's up. We're going to have a sub for him, it looks like.
Now we'll have an injury sub as the clock will stop. I believe that's number 12, Sebastian Heretic. He's coming off the field, walking a little gingerly. Didn't see exactly what happened. When play resumes, 14. It'll be a throw in for Monmouth on the near side.
14
for 12.
Coming in is number 14, Eric Hernandez, a sophomore out of Chicago, Illinois. Beat a drop ball as Monmouth kicks it over to Lawrence. Dermo looking to make a move. Finds Slansky on the far sideline. Logic can't keep control of that pass and it'll go into the goalie's hands, Connor Temple. 33 minutes remaining in this first half. Still scoreless. Sun to the middle for Paschese. We'll kick it back to Berger.
How far do you think Correa was outside the box? Was she inside the box when she took that shot?
She was inside.
Was she inside the box?
That'll be a foul against the Scots. So free kick upcoming for the Vikings.
She was like about distance where the penalty kick, her penalty kick line then is.
Just outside the end zone.
Yeah.
Who's Berger taking it? Sends it into the box. Headed away by the Scots. Lansky looked to put it back in. Guzman kicks it ahead. Looking for Daniels. Daniels gets a couple and then fires it at the net, but that one's way high and over the bar. So a goal kick coming for the Vikings.
Thank you.
stick the head looking for Blodgett. It goes right into the hands of Temple, and he'll roll it out to Seeley. Miranda over to Adams. Almost intercepted there by Darimo. Can't keep control of it though, and now Seeley back to Oldman. And they'll play it back to Adams again. Lawrence now with possession, they'll play it to their back line. This one kicked ahead looking for Alvarez. He can't get to it, so it'll roll out of bounds.
Or throw it.
Sutton with it on the near side. Back to Sutton. Pass easy to Lobel. Passes to Leonard. His attempted pass is blocked by Seeley, and that'll go out of bounds. Throw in for the Scots. Just under 29 minutes remaining in this first half. No really threatening chances by either team so far in this one. It's been played mostly at midfield. There's another pass looking for Blodgett, throwing for the Vikings on the far side. Kicked out of bounds again by the Scots. Darimo looking to throw it in. That's intended for Alvarez and kicked away by the Monmouth defense. So a throw in now at midfield for Lawrence. Lawrence will play it to their back line. Darimo now with it in the middle. Passes it to Sutton on the near side. Sutton back to Darimo. He looks to make a spin move. That'll be a foul though on number 11, Daniel Guzman. So free kick for Lawrence coming about 50 yards away from the net. Nick Huth taking the free kick for the Vikings. One's headed out of bounds by Lawrence, so throw in
who they're playing. They're 45
for the Scots. Thank you. and finds Solansky on the far side. He's in the box looking to find someone in the middle. Alvarez comes cutting in. That one's deflected just enough on a slide by Daniel Guzman.
With 3 minutes left in the second quarter.
Probably the best opportunity so far for either team.
It's atrocious. Ah, yeah, that's not good.
Now here's Alvarez. Try to put one in on net.
Oh.
Had some curve to it, but that one will sail wide and go for a goal kick. Good idea by Alvarez. Got a good look at the net. Just wasn't accurate enough. ...25 minutes remaining in the first half. Darren Lowe to Sutton. Sutton out to Alvarez. Nice move by Alvarez.
Nice look.
Create some space and find Solansky across the field.
Nice.
Solansky looks to put one on the net, but that one's blocked before it can get anywhere. Darren Lowe's pass is deflected, out of bounds, so throw in for the Vikings. Good stretch right here for Lawrence. Getting some good movement on offense and a few opportunities. Alvarez trying to control it. Just can't, and it'll be cleared out by the Scots. That one will be cleared out by Guzman. Have to re-throw it in. Berger will play it back to Krivit. Dermot across field, and here's Sutton on the near side. He's got some space. He'll put one towards the middle of the box. I think he was expecting a runner. Nobody there, though, and it'll go out of bounds for another goal kick.
Wow. Spencer Thompson-Myers kicked a 51-yard field goal for St. Norbert. They're up 46-6.
Must have a strong wind going there.
Just look. Dang.
Uh oh. The offside flag is up. So free kick coming for Lawrence.
McAllister's beating Carroll 14-6 at the half.
So it's like 13, I think, coming in for us.
Alvarez with a nice flick to Lobel. Lobel looking to create some space. He's got some. Cross it to the middle. Nobody in the middle, but Solansky on the other end. He puts one towards the net. That one is in right at Temple.
13 and 25 are coming in for us.
So he'll catch it.
13 and 25.
Lawrence, over the last 10 minutes or so, has had a pretty good offensive attack. Advantage called by the referee. Nice slide by Berger to keep it away from Guzman, so no great opportunity there. Now here is Ruiz. That one's headed up in the air by Miranda and caught by Krivit. So what looked like a threatening opportunity, stuffed out by the Vikings. Good job by Berger on the initial play to get in there and poke it away, because Guzman had almost a straight shot on net from just inside the box. Alvarez finds Lobel. He's looking for Solanski on the far side. He's trying to make a move. Just can't handle it enough and gets out of his reach for and goes out of bounds for a goal kick.
Who's coming
and Lawrence on? Now will have three subs.
23. 11.
And nine.
Leonard, Alvarez, and Blodgett will come out of the game.
Substitutions for Lawrence. Checking in number 13, John Singus, 25, Keenan Wilson, and number 7, Sean Garwood.
John Singus made a move and got fouled, so a free kick coming for Lawrence from about 45 yards out. Darimo taking the free kick. That one's headed towards the put on it! And that's a goal for Lawrence!
I believe that's Berger
who put it in. Yeah. He gets tackled by Lobel on the celebration.
I mean, for long.
That was off the tip from the goalie, right?
Yep.
It was a header that was tipped by the goalie and left him out of position.
Coming in for them.
Berger comes in, finishes it off, and gives Lawrence a 1-0 lead. Nice play off the set piece for the Vikings.
Why they won an offside.
This goal comes with 18 minutes, 5 seconds remaining in the first half.
24.
Another foul on Monmouth and another free kick coming for Lawrence from...
Yeah, I'm not sure who the assists are. We'll have to find out afterward.
Let's see where they put the ball.
I think you could give them one off the header and off
just
where
just over 40 yards out. See if the Vikings can...
The Lawrence goal scored by number 3, Lewis Berger.
Mikey played it in there, and then I didn't see who the header
was. So Dermot taking a free kick again. Either.
Same play, look at that.
That one's headed.
Oh!
Another shot by Lawrence. That one...
Solanski.
By Solanski. Good look on
the
net.
Header.
Just couldn't control it. That
yeah,
one.
That would,
I thought it was
okay.
Dom or
for
son.
A goal kick.
I think it was Dom.
Okay.
Kick it to him again there, too.
Substitution for Monmouth, number 20, Zeb Chanier.
Zeb Chanier in for Monmouth, a sophomore out of Durango, Colorado.
Okay, I'm going to go back and edit that part.
To Django.
So I'm going to say 10 and 21 on the assists. Okay, bingo. Done.
That one's out of bounds. Throw in coming for Lawrence and
19 coming in for.
They'll also have a sub in for them. Is number
10 out for us?
23 in for us.
So 23.
No, 20's in for us.
20's in for us.
So 20.
Eight out for them.
Taylor Reifert.
In.
Who came in for
who,
them?
19 for 8 for them?
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
And 20, who came out for us?
10.
Yeah. 20 for 10. Okay. Substitutions for the Vikings, number 20, Taylor Reifert, and for Monmouth, number 19, Josh Sutherland.
Free kick taken by Lawrence. Can't find anybody, so the Scots come away with it. Advantage played. This one goes back to Seeley.
That's a big guy. 16 as well.
19, 16 to 100.
He looks bigger than that. Sneak.
Out of bounds, throw in coming for the Vikings. Just under 15 minutes left in this first half. Nice play for Lawrence. And they'll have a throw in on the far side. I think they were asking for a foul on the initial play. I think it was Keenan Wilson who got bumped after making the pass to Lobel.
That's a Chris Keel.
He's kicked towards the middle. Reifert trying to get there. Just can't get a foot on it to direct it into the net.
No.
Solanski trying to find some room to operate. He'll kick it to the back line. With Berger. Hey, Aaron, go. Sutton with it. He passes it to Reifert. Reifert back to Berger. Zingas can't get ahead on that one, but Berger will get it again. With that one board looking for pretty much anybody who could get to it. Two guys in the air. This one's passed across the field to Sutton. He's got some room. Nice play by Seeley for the Scots to just get that one out of bounds. And we'll have another sub in for Lawrence.
2 for 7.
Boxes. The Scots will just kick it out of bounds, so throwing on the near side. This one's trying to get back to the middle. Seeley can't get a foot on that, a solid foot on that one, and it'll just roll out of bounds about 5 yards in front of him. Haskeezy with it, kicks it back to Tsingas. Tsingas looking for the cross, deflected, and cleared out by number 11, Daniel Guzman.
And that's going to be a goal kick.
As Sutton's kick will go out of bounds. 11 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the first half. Lawrence leads this one 1-0. Off a goal by Lewis Berger. The advantage called initially, but it'll be called back for a foul against Lawrence on the ground is number 14 for the Scott, Eric Hernandez. So free kick coming. Justin Seeley will take it for
28 coming in for them.
Monmouth. This one from about 37 yards out, or 47 yards out, excuse me.
Okay, stoppage.
28-16.
So 28 for 16?
Yep.
Sub coming in for Monmouth. Number 28, Lewis Bedang, a junior out of Worthington, Ohio. Monmouth looking to set up their set piece. Bedang gets it right away. This one, an attempted shot there by number 6, Augustine Miranda. But that one goes wide, so just a goal kick for the Vikings.
Fifth time since he's tied his shoes.
Velcro, dude.
You know, you can double knot those.
Ooh. This one tried to find Sutton on the near side. Just too much behind it, and it rolls out of bounds for Scott's throwing.
Like the Sphinx. Oh, jeez. Just kicked Huth right in the gut.
Huth gets that one. That one popped in the air.
Nice.
Singus hits it off of Seeley, so a throw in for the Vikings. Sutton with it. Gets pressured by Bedang. Another throw in for the Vikings. Here's Paschisi in the middle of the field.
Nice.
We're back.
Was kicked out of bounds by the Scots. So their corner kick coming for Lawrence. Taking it will be number 13, John Singus. And that one's headed away by Bedang. Really looking for Bedang. Some contact there, but nothing called. Lawrence gets possession back. Good defense by them. Looked like the Scots might have had something going on that one. Kicked ahead, and they'll just roll into the hands of Temple. Just under 8 minutes now remaining in the first half.
I believe young Kate Francoeur going for the sectional championship today with his Oshkosh North soccer team.
Oh, yeah.
It's the starting goalie for these Spartans.
What year is she?
Steve's son.
Oh.
He's a senior. He's looking at coming here.
Oh, is it?
Here or I guess he's looking at the University of Chicago.
Oh yeah, he's the one who got a really high ACT in here.
Yeah, I think he's pretty smart.
Did you say Cade?
Cade.
I thought you said Kate.
Oh. Yeah, I thought you said Cade.
No, Cade. C-A-D-E. Yeah, he wants to go to med school. Dr. Francoeur. I said that to Steve and he's like, man, that just is too weird.
Kicked out of bounds by the Scots, so another throw in coming for Lawrence.
stays there.
Wilson finds Solansky. Solansky tries to make the pass in. Garwood with a shot, but that one's blocked and kicked away by the Scots. Good play there by Lawrence.
Grab him.
A lot of contact with Pesci in that one. Nothing called, though.
There's four on the guy's face.
Is that wrong?
Is this okay?
Was that wrong?
Where's this offense been all year?
No kidding. Well, they did the same thing against Ripon. He only really dominated playing. And Ripon's not great, but...
I think he's trying to make a move, but that one's...
You know, they could have beaten Ripon 5 or 6 to nothing.
It's all about confidence, you know?
By number 14,
well,
Fernandez.
Find the right combination, too. You know, maybe they hit on some combinations here that they like.
Purdue and Nebraska keep trading.
Kicked out of bounds, let it throw in for Lawrence. They've... pretty much dominated possession in this one. A little uncharacteristic of them. They usually try to find counter opportunities. This one has been played mostly on the Monmouth side. 5 minutes remaining in the first half. Move to the far side to Solanski. He was looking for Christopher Keel. Was kicked out of bounds by the Scots.
Never seen Aaron Sutton involved this much in the attack either.
Singus with a move, he makes some room. It's by another defender. Pesci. Just find someone, that's number 15. Connor Oldman gets a foot in there and breaks up that attack for Lawrence. I think Riper thought Singus was going to be making a run on the near side. Miscommunication between them and Reifert.
Oh, there's another sport umbrella.
Yeah, no, there's two of them.
Wow. Notices it immediately.
Got a 2-for-1 discount on
them? Must be Mom's thing.
Reifert put some pressure on, forcing Scott to just boot that one down the field. Booth almost mishandles that as that's pressure put on by number 20, Zeb Soinger.
Zeb's dead.
Zeb's dead, baby. Whose motorcycle is this? Same motorcycle that you're driving.
Mm-hmm. Oh, here we go.
I'll put you.
I wasn't a big fan of that movie.
It's one of them. It was one of the more interesting things I've ever seen at that point. Just, it was so different than anything else that was out. And the scene in the basement thing, you know, you're just like...
That one's kicked out of bounds, throwing for the Vikings. Like 2.5 minutes remaining in the half. Good half so far played by Lawrence. Looking to continue the strong play through the end. They've been susceptible to late half and late game goals. So looking to finish this half out strong and go in to the stoppage with a 1-0 lead.
Speaking of PGA Championship umbrella there.
Nice. Sutton looking for
Wilson. 2 minutes remaining in the half. Yeah. 2 minutes.
You can't change directions fast enough, and that'll go into the hands of Temple.
Touch there,
finds number 11, Daniel Guzman, but that's a nice play by Booth. To regain possession of the ball. Nobody on the receiving end by the pass from Hernandez. Just under a minute now, left in the half. We'll play back to Krivit. Lawrence in no rush. Sutton with it. Pass finds Wilson. Wilson out at Singus. He's looking to make a move. Singus creates some space. But the Monmouth defense collapses just in time, preventing him from getting a shot off. Nothing called there by the ref. A lot of contact. Two guys go down. 13 seconds left in the half.
10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
It's a slide from behind. That's a foul, but that'll take us into the half. So Lewis